Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Corrections with a server from Gigabyte, the Gigabyte E263-Z34. With that E in the name, this system is an edge server, and as an edge server, it features a short chassis depth. It supports a single AMD EPYC 9004 or 9005 series CPU and 12 memory module slots to take advantage of the 12-channel memory architecture. Like our channel? Then hit that subscribe button. Need a little more time on that important decision? Then let's get to it. This system is designed for just about anything that you need at the edge. Networking, visual computing, AI, AI inference and training, plus use as a hybrid private cloud server. Clearly, it's highly adaptable. And with just a single socket, you can realize some cost savings as well. For AI support, this system can be outfitted with up to two dual slot Gen 5 GPUs. Let's check out the front of this system. There's no storage up front, but you can see a bank of four large fans through the perforated panel. A small control panel on the right includes a power on button and unit ID button. Above that, a reset button and non-maskable interrupt button. What's the difference between a reset button and non-maskable interrupt, you might be asking yourself? Well, maybe not, but I'll tell you anyways. The reset button will do just that, shut down and reboot the system. The non-maskable interrupt, or NMI button, is a high priority interrupt that goes a bit deeper than just resetting the system. If there is a critical error and the reset button does not work, the next step is that NMI button. It will force the system to submit to debugging or recovery. It triggers a processor exception error and allows for diagnostics instead of just rebooting the system. That may be a little simplistic, but let's move on. But before I do that, a question. Are you interested in the Gigabyte E263-Z34 Edge server? Because if you are, then here's the deal. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. If that sounds like a good deal, then click that link to check out IT Creations and configure a system. Using our configurator, you can easily see what you can get for your budget. You can also directly contact one of our sales guys if you need some help. Just mention this video when you're ready to make a purchase to reap the rewards. ITCreations.com. Below the big buttons, LEDs for HDD status, system status, then LAN 1 and LAN 2. There are two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports on the right. On the rear of the system is where there are two 2.5-inch drive bays supporting Gen 5 NVMe, SATA, or SAS-4 drive types. If you want SAS drives, then you will need a storage controller. Just below, two 2000-watt 80-plus titanium power supplies offer 1+1 redundancy. There are two OCP 3.0 slots on the bottom that can be used for NICs or even an optional storage adapter. Between those, an I/O panel with a mini display port, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, a dedicated management port, and then a data LAN port with ID button beside that. Above, PCI slots. With Gigabyte, you do get a pretty sweet deal for managing the system via a specialized processor on the system board. The Gigabyte management console comes pre-installed and free of charge, enabling administrators remote access to the system through a standard browser-based graphical user interface or a command line interface. It's compatible with the standard Intelligent Platform Management Interface, or IPMI, specifications. It's suitable for managing this single server or a small cluster. If you have a larger network of appliances, there's Gigabyte Server Management. Gigabyte Server Management is available for download and allows for managing clusters of servers simultaneously once you install the GSM agent on each of the systems you intend to access. It is compatible with IPMI and Redfish standards and offers several other utilities for real-time remote access, plus mobile app and a plugin for VMware vCenter. Cracking the case on this system, you can see those fans up front just behind the front panel, so guaranteed there are no additional drives going up front. A fan shroud helps direct fresh air over the CPU, memory modules, and then over the PCI slots and the power supplies in back. The CPU is flanked by six memory module slots to each side, with a PCIe 3.0x4 slot on the side of one bank for an M.2 drive. That M.2 drive can be used for additional storage or to boot the system. There are definitely a number of MCIO connectors for support of SATA or NVMe drives, but you really only need one of them for those two drives in the back. Standard CPUs supported on this system include those at up to 400 watts or up to 500 watts with an ambient temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, which is about 77 degrees. Given that, you can install the top-of-the-line 9005 series CPU with up to 192 physical cores and 384 virtual threads. 5th-gen AMD EPYC processors also have a substantial L3 cache at up to 512 megabytes. Also are supported 4th-generation AMD EPYC processors. Those offer a top core count of up to 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads. With the 4th Gen X suffix CPUs, that offers 3D V-cache technology, you can get more cache from 768 megabytes to 1152 megabytes. Feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, but as I understand it, AMD has not released a 5th Gen EPYC CPU with 3D V-cache technology, yet. DDR4 registered DIMMs are supported on this system. I will also tell you that CPUs with a P suffix means it's optimized for single socket platforms. However, that doesn't mean you can't install that 192-core AMD EPYC 9965 CPU. You will get more PCI lanes with the non-P suffix CPUs at up to 160 lanes compared to 128 PCI 5.0 lanes with P suffix CPUs. Hardly matters though, as the platform is not going to be maxing out the PCI lanes. Given there are only 12 slots and both generations support 12-channel memory architecture, memory speed is dependent on the memory modules installed and the CPU generation. With 5th Gen, you get a top memory speed of up to 6400 MHz. With 4th Gen, up to 4800 MHz. The memory modules can also support a slower speed depending on what you purchase. In fact, there are only two PCI 5.0 by 16 slots for double-wide GPUs, and that includes either NVIDIA or AMD GPUs, but no mixing. I already told you about those OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slots, but those too have a PCI 5.0 by 16 interface. That would make 64 PCI 5.0 lanes, and then you can add in the M.2 slot at by 4 for 68 lanes, and those four pairs of MCIO connectors at 4 apiece for 32 more lanes on top of the 68 lanes for 100 PCI 5.0 lanes, potentially. But as I said earlier, only two drive bays, so you're only going to be using one of those MCIO connectors, and we're at about 72 lanes, much less than the CPU is capable of supporting. There are only a few GPUs listed in the specifications for the Gigabyte E263-Z34, but I'm quite sure it's incomplete as testing is quite expensive. Listed in the optional parts sections are power cables for the NVIDIA A100 and AMD Instinct MI210 GPUs. An NVIDIA A100 with Tensor Cores has a power draw of up to 300 watts, with the 80GB version or 250 watts with the 40GB version. The MI210, on the other hand, has 64GB of HBM2 e-memory and a power draw of 300 watts. Also mentioned, but in the qualified vendor list, or QVL, are two additional GPUs, the A40 with 48GB memory and the RTX A6000, both with a power draw of up to 300 watts. All of these cards with a PCI 4.0 by 16 interface, and mostly for graphics-intensive workloads, but the A100 and A40 are also geared towards AI and HPC applications. The Gigabyte E263-Z34 Edge Server is a very flexible and adaptable platform for a variety of workloads. Given its small footprint, it does provide a substantial base for Edge workloads. If you have any questions on this platform or any other, post them in the comment section below. If you're looking for more information on this system or want to configure one based on your specifications, then I placed a few links below, or you can use that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.